I'm so excited to be here, and it's been quite an experience, even though we're only halfway through the day. It's been awesome. So yeah, I'm really excited about it. I think it's the dynamic of family. I think no matter, you know, whether you are a part of the biker culture or not, you can relate to having people in your life that you consider family that you would, you know, go above and beyond for, that, you know, that are really important to you, and you know, all the things that the club went through. I think anybody can kind of relate to that. I mean, minus the killing, obviously. But, you know, I think the family dynamic of the show and what that really represents, there's all different kinds of facets that you can fit that into in your day-to-day real life, you know? So I think that's what really touched people. My experience was I had a lot of fun, and I now have, you know, like 8 brothers that I never had before, and I'm just really lucky to be able to call them family, and you know, and have these experiences with them, and you know, travel the world and meet our fans and meet people who are just awesome, and it's, you know, it's kind of surreal at moments where you're like, this is my job, this is, you know, it's just really cool, and we're all very, very grateful for the fans and how much they love us and how much they give back. You know, we love each and every one of them too, so it's pretty awesome. My character added destruction and, you know, just the bad girl quality that I think every show kind of needs. And I think, you know, she was a lot of fun to play. Oh, man, she was a lot of fun to play. And I do miss her terribly. You know, and this is going to sound awful because so many people, it was a moment that they still cringe when they watch. But when Jax beats me up, I think is probably one of my favorite moments from the series, because it was very brutal, but it was also, you know, it was a pivotal moment for both of our characters. And I think that, you know, remains like a very intense moment in my filming history. You know, I haven't had many scenes that kind of intense and that dramatic. And you know, Charlie, bless his heart, he didn't want it to be that violent. He didn't want it to go there. And I said, you know what? She totally deserves it. So go for it. I think with this particular show, it was keeping it authentic. You know, I don't think these guys would be as rough as they are and then not follow through with you know, the violence aspect. And it is, you know, In the 1% MC, you know, there's a lot of times where you have to kind of resort to that to either get your point across or to get something done, unfortunately. So, you know, I think it was Kurt trying to stay authentic to that particular genre. And I think, you know, it adds that extra layer on a show that you know, that extra intensity that keeps people tuning back in to see what, you know, what the hell is going to happen next week, you know, so... I think it adds that little extra layer that just really grips you, you know? Charlie is a very rare human in this business. He's got a heart of gold, and he really, really cares about his craft, and he really, really cares about people, and he really wants everybody to have the best experience they can, and he's just a good soul, and I think that he was able to, because of that, he was able to bring to the character of Jax those different layers, those different dynamics, and you know, almost like the contradictory of the violence that he would sometimes have to portray alongside, you know, this really beautiful soul, this really big bleeding heart. So I think there were, you know, he was the only one that could ever play that character, and he did it so well. You know, we're all now madly in love with him, of course. Yes, I absolutely love me some Ron. He is one of my favorites. And I didn't, you know, we all know him from different jobs that he's had and whatnot. But I, you know, I show up to set and I'm so intimidated by all of these guys. And I'm just kind of sitting there keeping quiet. And he just walks onto set and he's telling some sort of dirty joke. And I remember just falling out of my chair laughing, thinking, I had no idea he was this funny. I mean, you know, because he doesn't necessarily play those characters. And he was just, he's by far one of the funniest human beings I've met. And I was just so floored by how just funny he was and how dirty that joke was. And it was, so yeah, the behind the scenes stuff for Ron definitely was key. I just a couple weeks ago had a film released on like iTunes and all of those good video on demand platforms called Battle Scars. And then I actually just finished shooting two other films that should be coming out next year. And after this, I go start one of four. So, you know, I'm excited. Yeah. Well, I can't talk too much about them until, you know, they're done. Yeah. But I'll keep everybody posted via social media and, you know, you can check it out. Battle Scars is a movie about a guy coming back from the war in Iraq and his readjustment into society. And it touches on a lot of, you know, topics that PTSD, traumatic brain injury, things like that. It's a very dark, very deep, very real story. And of course I play a bad girl again. I mean, duh, why would I not? But it's a very, I'm proud to be a part of that film because it has a message that I think is really important. You know, and it starts a conversation that I think needs to be had. So, I'm very proud to be a part of that film. So yeah, check it out. It's on, I believe, you know, pretty much anywhere, Amazon, iTunes, all those good video on demand places. Hi guys, thank you for tuning in, and we love you, and we just thank you for all the support over the years. You're just awesome and great.